I wish I didn't have to talk about this tonight. I wish we didn't have to talk about the racist part of yet another American politician, another of our leaders who publicly trafficked in racism, who proudly wore some of the most offensive symbols in this nation's history. And I wish we didn't have to talk about this on the first night of Black History Month. Maybe it's good we're having this discussion. But how many discussions like this are we going to have? Our history is full of Americans who were proud to parade their racism publicly. The evidence is right here, in black and white. A page from a 1984 medical school yearbook of Democratic Governor Ralph Northam of Virginia, showing a photo of two people, one in blackface, one in a KKK hood and robe. There it is, look at it. Governor Northam admits he is one of the people in that picture. He doesn't say whether he's the one in blackface or the one in the KKK robe. Can you put that back up? Can we just put it back up? Does it matter, though? They're equally as disgusting and offensive. The governor put out a statement tonight.
That photo and the racist and offensive attitudes it represents does not reflect that person I am today or the way that I have conducted myself as a soldier, a doctor, and a public servant. I am deeply sorry. I cannot change the decisions I made, nor can I undo the harm my behavior caused then and today.
So here are some important points. First, he apologized. He didn't resign, though. There's another thing the governor knew about this picture. He says he made the decision to appear in it. It is part of his past. And it's not so distant past. This was a yearbook photo from 1984, not 1954. He was 25 years old. He was in medical school. There's no way he didn't know what he was doing when he posed for that picture. A picture that is a slap in the face to Americans of color. Quite frankly, to every American. This matters, it should matter to every single one of us. None of us can forget what happened in Virginia and Charlottesville in 2017. White supremacists, neo-Nazis, marching in the streets. Counter-protester Heather Heyer murdered, mowed down by a white supremacist who drove his car into the crowd. None of us can forget what the President of the United States said.
You also had people that were very fine people on both sides. You had people in that group, excuse me, I saw the same pictures as you did.
That is why it was so important for the President to emphatically say, one side did something really terrible and it shouldn't happen, but he didn't. He had to do the whole on both sides thing. On both sides. There are certain situations, and you hear me talk about it all the time, where there's no both sides. There's no both sides to racism. There's no both sides to sexism. There is no both sides to fact and a non-fact, or reality and not reality. There's no both sides to the truth and a lie. There's no both sides to this. And when I saw it, quite frankly, I wasn't surprised. If anybody out there, all the folks who went to high school with me, around the time 1984, I was a senior in high school in 1984. That is not shocking to me. People did that in 1984. It was not right. They thought it was funny. They laughed. And they paid no consequences because that's the way things were. And it was not so long ago. So all of these people who are either feigning shock or surprise, or if you're really shocked and surprised, you have been living in a bubble. Because this was the reality, especially for people like me in Louisiana and in southern states. I can't speak for the North, but this is not shocking. People did this all the time. And I know there are a lot of people out there who've got some photo worry going on. Oh my gosh, what is gonna pop up with me right now? I know friends who's got photos of me and I wouldn't want... Listen, kids do stupid things. They take photos. They do dumb things. But this is more than dumb, this is racist. And if you're making an excuse for this, saying, oh, this is what happened when this person was young. They were in high school. They were in college. They were in medical. They were a young person. If you're making an excuse for it, you need to check yourself. It wasn't, and that's why I got so upset with the whole blackface. You remember that when I said blackface was not cool then? We were talking about a major news anchor saying that was blackface. This is why people are so upset, because they think that it was okay, but it wasn't. It hurt. It deeply hurt people like me. Deeply hurt people like me. So if you even thought it was okay, or if you're someone like Ralph Northam, then you owe people like me in this country a huge apology before you get on your high horse and get upset and say, oh my gosh, you're being too rough on people. You know what you can do with that being too rough on people? Put it where the sun don't shine. Ralph Northam talked about Trump's both sides remarks just 1 month later. Quote, I regret that the president of this great country of ours did not denounce what they were there for. He didn't call it out. I'm talking about Charlottesville. He didn't call it out for what it was. Racism is not just something from our collective past. Just last week, Florida Secretary of State Michael Erdl resigned after photos of him at a party in blackface as a Katrina victim were publicly revealed. That was last week. Governor Northam has apologized, but is that enough? A lot of top Democrats, members of his own party, well, they don't think so. Senators Kirsten Gillibrand, Kamala Harris, Elizabeth Warren, Congressman Eric Swalwell, Julian Castro have all called on him to resign. I'm going to talk to Julian Castro in just moments here on this program. And the Virginia House Democratic Caucus is having a conference call right now to discuss this situation. Democrats who've called out President Trump for his racist remarks cannot try to sweep this one under the rug just because Ralph Northam is one of their own. Like I said, I wish we didn't have to talk about this. But the evidence is right there in black and white. Or I should say right there in blackface. Sarah Seidner joins us now with more. Hi, Sarah. Good evening to you.
You said it, Don. Look, the Democratic governor of Virginia, Ralph Northam, is having to answer a question that I don't think any governor, any politician would want to answer in the 21st century. Are you the guy in blackface, or are you the guy wearing the KKK robes? That is a question he actually needs to answer, although he has not yet answered that question. But certainly one of them is him. And he has admitted that one of the people in that photo is him. The picture is from a 1984 yearbook when Ralph Northam was at the Eastern Virginia Medical School. He was an adult. He was somewhere around 25 years old when that picture was taken. Here's more of what he said after admitting that, indeed, one of those photos, either the guy in blackface or the person wearing the KKK robes, is indeed him. And here's how he has responded to some of that.
I accept responsibility for my past actions, and I am ready to do the hard work of regaining your trust. I have spent the past year as your governor fighting for a Virginia that works better for all people. I am committed to continuing that fight through the remainder of my term and living up to the expectations you set for me when you elected me to serve.
So what you heard there was that he is planning on continuing his term and not resigning. That's what's happening right now in the hours after this came out. I want to mention something else that just came out. There is a yearbook photo from his time when he was in college in 1981, when he was going to school at the Virginia Military Institute. You'll see the picture there. Now, underneath that picture, it says, what are his nicknames? And one of his nicknames is Goose, and the other nickname is Coon Man. Now, you well know that Coon is one of the most insulting black characters from the Jim Crow South. And so there is more evidence that there was definitely something in his mind that made that okay, because then 4 years later or 3 years later, he is pictured as either a person in blackface or a person wearing KKK robes. So if you're one of those folks who thinks that racism is not a part of our fabric, of America's fabric, our politicians keep on giving you a clue that it certainly, definitely is, Don.